one. After that, if you can see guys, there is a marking here.
There are marking here. Just to be sure, we have to mark it again.
So I'm using this one for marking.
Limit, then we have to replace all this.
Okay.
All of these seats are out of limit. This exhaust, this one, intake, these are out of limit. So all of this has to be replaced. So the procedure, guys, we need to remove first this valve guide. By welding. So this is how to remove. This is how I remove.
This is how I remove the valve. I show you this one.
So we have to weld this one by arc welding. After we weld this one, so we can remove it. Throw out all these seats. These seats are out of limit. So we have to remove all. So this is how I remove, guys. So we will proceed now to welding. Try to remove it. as you can see guys, that's how simple is that. So that is how to remove the valve seat. So this is a special tool for the valve guide. Sure that these holes are free. Otherwise it will dry. It will be difficult to install. So you need to be real quick guys. We're installing this one. Now engine room temperature is a little bit high. So we need this. Okay. to same ring, you have to lubricate. That things need to be checked. This one, so it's clear, no leaking from here. So we'll check from downside. There is some leaking here, then we have to replace again. So in this case, no leakage from exhaust. See, other side, there's no leakage, guys. So we are clear, it's all clear, no leakage, and we will check the pressure. So as you can see, the pressure is still the same. After the pressure test, then we will proceed with the lapping. Now we are clear that we are sure that no leakage from the seals. We will proceed now lapping with the valve assist. So as we change the valve assist, guys, we will also replace the valve itself. If you can see, they are identical. So this is the exhaust, this is the intake. Normally, there should be marking here with intake or exhaust here. But in this case, guys, there is no marking, so how can we identify this is intake or exhaust? So I give you one tip, guys, is based from my experience. So if situation like this, then you have to check the seats, the valve, the seats of the valve. If you can differentiate, obviously this is bigger and this is smaller seats on the valve. So if you can see smaller, then this is the exhaust. If you can see wider, this is the intake. This one is the intake. As you can see, they are obviously different. So as you can see, guys. So this is the exhaust. This is the intake. If you look from distance, they are identical. But if you look closer, guys, you can see they are different. with the seeds. So if you can see the smaller, this one, smaller one, this one, the seeds is smaller. Then this is the exhaust and this is the intake, the wider one. Okay? So now guys, we will proceed down to lapping. So I'm using this one. This is the medium. Even if this is new, we need to lapping just to confirm they are making contact 100%. That way, guys. So I'm using spring to little lubricate. Lapping paste going down there from bulk guide. So this is how I lap it, guys.
So we have completed our overhauling, guys. And I hope you learned something from this video. If you have any comments or suggestions, please feel free to comment down below. And if you are interested in this kind of video, guys, please hit like and subscribe button. See you in my next video. This is JB23.